Hey, good morning, guys. I hope you're enjoying the beautiful sunshine. It is an absolutely beautiful morning. It's going out to, I don't know why I wrote this the way I wrote this, so I couldn't figure it out, but I believe it's Janitor, J-A-N-I, as in India, T, E as in Echo, R, as in Romeo, Janitor. And then it's, I believe it's in a drum. India, November, Alpha, Delta, Romeo, Uniform, Mike. Or it could be in a drum. India, November, Alpha, Tango, Romeo, Uniform, Mike. Dude, I am so sorry if I'm butchering your name, but you know who you are. At any rate, this one's going out to you. It is Jimmy Castor, or the Castor Bunch. Jimmy Castor Bunch. And it is Troglodytes. He gave me three songs of theirs, and this was by far, like, their other two songs that you gave me had, like, 1,000, 2,000 views. This one was, like, in the millions. Millions of views. I don't know. We're going to check it out. Let's see what's going on here. I've never heard of them. Cause like they're like a throwback group. Like, I mean, like this is from back in the day, right? I don't know. Let's find out.
What we're gonna do right here is go back, way back, back into time.
Okay.
When the only people that existed were troglodytes. Cavemen.
Troglodytes.
Cave women.
Okay.
Neanderthal. Troglodytes. Let's take the average caveman at home listening to his stereo.
Ooh, I like. Oh, this is some funky shit, man. I love funk. All right. I gotta take this back. This is a funk band? Oh, I'm down for this shit. I love funk, man. All right, okay.
At home, listening to his stereo.
Yeah, because the cavemen had stereos, just so you know. They invented the wheel, which in turn became the turntable. So they had stereos.
Sometimes he'd get up, try to do his thing. He'd begin to move, something like this, dance.
By the way, you gotta listen to this with headphones on. You know how some songs, like, you have to have headphones on, especially the older songs, because you're getting one sound in your left ear and one sound in your right ear? AC/DC Hell's Bells is like that. Back in Black's like that. A lot of the old rock and roll songs are like that because they purposely do it. So you're getting songs. This song's doing it too. Sorry. There's just so much going on in this song and I'm so intrigued because it's got the funky music in the background, but he's talking about caveman shit. I'm just like, I'm down with it, man. I'm so down with it. I'm sorry. I'll start from the beginning. I'm so down for this shit right now.
What we're gonna do right here is go back.
Okay.
Way back.
All right.
Back into time. When the only people that existed were troglodytes.
Up, baby.
Cave.
It's okay. cave. Jackson, up. Go in the chair. Go on, baby. Good boy.
Troglodytes. Let's take the average caveman at home, listening to his stereo. Sometimes he'd get up, try to do his thing.
Yeah.
He'd begin to move, something like this.
It's funny. I'm sorry. You can't do that today, fellas, because that shit might come off. He ain't lying either. It don't matter. Oh, maybe Asian women you'd be okay with, you know? But it don't matter. White, black, fucking... Everybody's got fucking extensions in their fucking hair these days, man. I don't. My shit's fucking natural. My hair comes down. When I have it straightened, it comes down almost to my ass. My hair's so long. But I have to have it straightened because my hair is... You guys have seen my hair. My hair is fucking just kinky, curly. It's a fucking curly mess, you know? So when I wear it natural... Yeah, it comes down probably chest length, like right there. But that's still fucking long. But even so, man, he's right. Probably about the only girl you can count on having like 100% natural hair are Asian girls. And it's because they just have fucking just beautiful goddamn hair. And it's thick and they can just grow that shit out. But... The rest of us, you don't fucking know. You just don't fucking know these days. That's some funny shit. Look at this picture. And she looks happy. She looks happy. She got a flower in one hair and she's being dragged by her hair.
Look around and just reach in and grab one. Come here.
Come here.
Come here. Grab her by the hair. You can't do that today, fellas, because it might come off. You'd have a piece of hair in your hand, she'd be swimming away from you. This one woman just laid there, wet and frightened. He said, move. Move. She got up. She was a big woman.
Big woman.
Big woman.
How big?
Her name was Bertha.
Bertha.
Bertha Butt.
Ooh, that's the other song that you asked for.
He didn't care. He looked up. He said, "Suck it to me, suck 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 it to me." She looked down on him. She was ready to crush him. But she began to like him. She said, I'll suck it to you, daddy. He said, what? She said, I'll suck it to you, daddy. You know what he said? He started it all way back then. I ain't gonna lie to you. When she said, I'll suck it to you, daddy. He said, right on. Right on.
Oh my God. No, it can't be over. Can't be over. Is it over? Oh my gosh. Now we have to hold on. It can't be over, and I'm telling you why. Give me a minute.
Bum bum bubba dum bum 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 bubba dum. Bum bum bubba dum bum 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 bubba dum. Bum bum bubba dum bum 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 bubba dum. The party was jumping when Bertha got off of her stump. The whistles were blowing and everybody did the bump. But all the time Bertha had been working on a goodie. Now folks call it the Bertha Butt Boogie. Question. When Bertha got moving, her hips were humming in the wind. The ground started shaking, no grass grew where she'd been. The music was popping, the crowd had formed a ring. Our sisters yelled, Boogie Bertha, do your thing! All for your information, Bertha had three sisters, Betty Butt, Bella Butt, and Bathsheba Butt.
Bathsheba Butt! Sorry, I'm gonna have to stop doing the butt boogie. It's hurting me too much. I'll do the shoulder boogie though. I'm sorry.
Oh, here comes the troglodyte. Come here. Sock it to me.
Oh, sock it to me.
Bertha stood back and yelled, Betty, Bella, Bathsheba. And the butt sisters backed her up when she yelled,
I need you.
The troglodyte, Leroy, Luther, and the Butt sisters all knew that the Bertha Butt Boogie was now the thing to do.
When Bertha Butt did her thing, she started a Bertha Butt Boogie.
No question.
Thank you so much for I don't know what the other song is that you requested. I mean, I know it. I have the title to it. I don't know if it fits into the Bertha trilogy, but I did see that this is Bertha number, the Bertha Boogie number one. There is a Bertha Boogie number two. I love this. And you know what it makes, because I'm going to admit this. Because growing up, and I lived in California through junior high, right? And there was a huge, like, I lived through the clash of the disco slash rock era, right? Where people were literally wearing t-shirts down the street with roller skates on, going down the sidewalks and everything, down by the pier and everything, by the ocean, wearing t-shirts that said disco sucks on the back of them. I mean, it was like there was literally a clash of the people who still love disco and the people who were now doing the rock and roll thing. I mean, it was a real, literally a real, like, movement that was going on there. But I have to tell you, my guilty pleasure, because I think everybody has a guilty pleasure, my guilty pleasure is the Gap Band. I absolutely love the Gap Band. Why haven't I reacted to them? Because I don't think people love them as much as I do. But how can you not, man? They had so many hits that are just like gems that I think it, when people hear them on the radio, they sing them not knowing that it's the Gap Band. They just remember the song, or they remember their parents playing the song and maybe dancing in the house together, or their mom kind of whatever it may be. I just love the Gap Band. When I was in high school, my boyfriend, my oldest son's father at the time, he had like a Gap Band gold tape that he wore the fuck out. Every time we got into his car, he would slap it into the tape player. And we just listened to the Gap Band all the time. I mean, I just have really good memories of the Gap Band. But this guy reminds me of the Gap Band. It's that same, the Gap Band, excuse me, you're going to unplug my computer. Can you get out of there? Come on. Dogs. Anyway, that, because the Gap Band wasn't, they got thrown into the disco category, but they were really more funk than they were disco. Yes, they did have some disco songs, but they were mostly just like funk, just pure funk, man. I'm going to have to do a Gap Band song. Maybe I'll do one today. Since I'm doing a lot of just really strange sounding songs today, I might do a Gap Band song. I don't even know what I'm doing today, but I hope you guys love this as much as I did. Thank you so much for requesting this. This was just, I don't know these people. I've never heard of them before. This was music I've never heard before, and it made me happy. I'm going to be in agony later. I'm going to have to take an extra pain pill because I'm recovering from surgery, and I might have popped a stitch out or something. I'm not sure because now I'm really in pain. But it was worth it to get my Boogie on as much as I could. Just to feel happy. Music makes me happy. I hope it made you happy too. You guys have a fantastic day. And please comment, like, subscribe, hit that notification bell so you know when I make my next video. And what else? Damn straight. You guys take care of each other because no one else is going to. Ciao.